More than 30 shots were fired. Machetes, meat cleavers and knives were brandished and used in what police believe is the latest outbreak of suburban gang warfare.
The Asian gangs involved don't fear our laws. There's one thing that they do fear: deportation back to the jungles of Vietnam.
A western suburban street becomes the sinister setting for a political assassination. Parliamentarian John Newman shot in cold blood in the carport of his Cabramatta home.
A friend of mine called me telling me that John Newman was assassinated. I said to myself, wow. This is going to be the biggest political issue in the Australian history.
Could this be related to his stance against Asian crime in the area?
It could well be. It's possible.
Mr. Newman's been the subject of a number of threats emanating from his role as a crusader here in Cabramatta.
All fingers would be pointed at the Vietnamese community. We need to be prepared for the onslaught.
State Labor MP John Newman viciously gunned down after a long-running campaign against Asian gang violence.
He was doing his job, and his job required that he defend an Asian community in Australia against the predators in that community. I don't think there's any doubt that that's why he paid the lesson he paid so tragically last night.
Once upon a time, Cabramatta was seen as a potential beacon of multiculturalism, proof that old white Australia was history. Not anymore.
The Newman murder is seen as a classic example of everything that's wrong with multiculturalism.
To gun down a member of parliament in his own home goes to the very fabric of what Australia's all about. We've got to have a look at what we're doing with this country. We've got to have a look where Australia's been, and particularly we've got to address where Australia's going. If they're people that weren't born in Australia, then deport them. Send them back to where they came from.